Recently, I sent an email to my mailing list called Goodbye Digital Products, Hello Pretty Pages. And a little bit of confusion arose from that. I got a lot of questions asking, is my website going away? Are the products going away? They are not. So I realized that it was a little confusing how I worded that. And honestly, the word digital products is very confusing. So I just wanted to clarify and help you feel comfortable that you're still in the right place and what we're talking about. So if you are new here, my name is Lisa. This is Pretty Fabulous. And our new tagline for this channel is I help online businesses create pretty pages like planners, notebooks, and stationery using Adobe InDesign. Now, what do I mean by goodbye digital products? So I had this epiphany right before COVID where I was like, you know what? I'm really going to go into talking more about how to create and sell digital products. Now, digital products, I have another video that talks about what are digital products. It's basically a lot of different things. It could be a photo stock library like Pixie Stock or her creative studio. It could be a music library I can't even think of the name of one, but there's a ton of different music clips that you can buy out there for your YouTube videos or for anything else. There are photo stock libraries. There are templates that you can buy. Those are digital products. Templates that are swipe files or things that are Trello boards, those are digital products. So digital products, I mean, courses obviously is a huge one, but it's a huge all-encompassing sort of generic term. It's almost like saying I'm on the internet, right? And so it was very trendy to say I help people with digital products. And really, the more I got into that and the more I thought about it, it's more about marketing, right? Like getting into funnels, how to do tripwires, how to build an audience. And that to me is just like teaching people how to start an online business, which is not something that I am passionate about teaching others. I am really more passionate about my original mission statement, which was just to help people create beautiful things using Adobe InDesign. So planners just seem to be a niche area that I have focused on. Notebooks, wedding invitations, as well as calligraphy. And so these are the areas that I really want to keep my focus on, as well as a new one is card decks. So all of these items can be one of three things. They can be a digital product that you can sell to somebody like a digital planner, or they could be a physical product like a actual hold it in your hands planner or notebook or card deck. It could also be a printable where you get the PDF, you print it out yourself, and maybe you cut the card deck at home on your own cardstock paper, or you send it to your own printer, right? So it's a printable that you can kind of do whatever you want with. And so that is really what I love doing. That's my passion. And so that is something I want to help you to create and design and then sell to others. So I'm more of what you call a B2B. I'm not trying to sell direct to consumers. I'm trying to help you to start your pretty pages business of planners or notebooks, or you can be a wedding invitation designer, or you can create card decks, right? So the difference is I wanted to originally, just because I thought it sounded trendy and cool, to teach people about digital products, but I've discovered that's not really a passion. I think I was just doing that because it sounded cool. I don't know. I'm trying to get over like the whole I'm just doing things to be cool and kind of fit in and I think are going to take off. Really just stick to things that I love doing. Because every time I've tried to do that, like writing, for example, romance was really popular. And I knew I always wanted to write mysteries. But because I kept hearing about how much money you can make in romance and how those sell way better and that people who really make a lot of money write romance, I had switched over to romance. But that's not really my passion. It's not really what I want to do. And so now I've switched back to mysteries and I'm much happier. And quite honestly, sales are going much better than they ever did in romance because it's more aligned with what I want to do. And so the same thing with Pretty Fabulous. I think I kind of went off on a small tangent there where I was like, you know, digital products sound really cool and trendy. Everybody is talking about them. But the truth is, I really love just helping people create and design pages of planners and workbooks and notebooks and card decks. And so that is what I will be sticking with. So I hope that helps clarify everything going on. And everything in the shop that is for sale, templates and everything else will stay because I am a B2B business where I try to help you to create and sell things that you can sell to consumers. I am not trying to sell things direct to consumers myself, and that's mostly because I just love teaching and helping other people to build a business, but specifically in those areas versus just kind of how to market in general. That's not really my thing. So I don't know if that clarified things or that just made it more confusing. Let me know if you have questions below. This is an extra Sunday video just to help even things out. And also, I had a bunch of digital product videos that I deleted because it's really not a focus anymore, as well as, I don't know if you guys followed, I had made a big announcement that I was doing blogging for Jessica Stansberry, who's a friend and has an amazing, amazing website, business, YouTube channels. You should definitely go follow her. And when we were talking about, like, she wanted everyone to blog on a specific subject, and I was like, digital products, I will only talk about digital products. And so all of my blog posts to now have been about that, but I've switched. She was super supportive. I'm going to still be blogging for her, but I'll be talking about what I'm sticking with, which is Pretty Pages, which is talking about planners, creating notebooks, creating card decks, being a wedding invitation designer, and calligraphy. So you can still follow me over there for blog posts. That's the only place I blog. And I will leave a link to her blog post site, or blog site, not blog post site, her blog below. And this channel will continue just to talk about things that we've always talked about. So there's a few videos on here where I talked about digital products. I will just leave those up. But just know that that's probably not just an area we're going to follow on. We will talk about, the only thing digital really is probably printables and digital planners, if we are talking about how to create what digital products that we'll be showing on here, as well as probably wedding invitation suites. I think you can sell those as pre-mades, and that could be a digital product if you sell it as a printable for a bride to take and go get printed somewhere else. So that was a longer way to explain why the email said goodbye digital products and hello pretty pages. All right, I hope everyone's having a fabulous Sunday, and I will see you on Monday with a new video. Bye.